Assalamu alaikum my dear students, hope you are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Welcome to NIEBS Home School. This is Shahzadi Akhtar, Assistant Teacher of Science of National Ideal English Version School, Day Shift. Today I am going to take a science class for class 1 students. Dear students, our today's topic chapter 2, reading done, page number 12 to 15. My dear students, our today's lecture number is 3 and SW number 2. So let's start our class. Our today's topic chapter 2, reading done. Okay, our chapter name is chapter 2. The chapter name is Living, the Living and Non-Living World. The Living and Non-Living World. Okay, we see many things in our surrounding. We see many things in our surrounding. These things can be divided into two groups. My dear students, this is very important line. So underline this line and you have to memorize this. We see many things in our surrounding. These things can be divided into two groups, living and non-living things. That means we have learned our surrounding. There are many things in our surrounding and these things can be divided into two groups, living and non-living. Look at the picture below. See this picture. What can we see? We can see there is a girl, a boy, bird, an elephant, and there is a butterfly, there is flowers, trees, and etc. etc. Okay, the things shown in the picture are called living things. That means they all, these things are living things. Okay, the things shown in the picture are called living things. Okay, what is called living things? People, animals and plants are living things. Okay, underline also this line. This line is also very very important for fill in the blanks and true false. Okay, people, animal and plants are living things. Living things eat, breathe, grow, move and give birth to babies like themselves. My dear students, underline also this line. This line is also important and you have to memorize. Okay, living things eat, breathe, grow, move and give birth to babies like themselves. Okay, my dear students, now go to next page. Okay, page number 13. Animals like cats, dogs, elephants and even men give birth to babies. My dear students, this also important line. Okay, underline this one and you have to memorize also this line. Animals like cats, dogs, elephants and even men give birth to babies. And birds like hens and ducks lay eggs from which young ones come out. Okay, now see this figure. Nature of living things. These are the nature of living things. Okay, now see this picture. Living things breathe. Okay, underline this line. This line is very very important and memorize this line. Living things breathe. Okay, is living things breathe? Yes, living things breathe. Living things grow. This is the also important line. Living things grow. See this figure. There is a baby and there is a man. That means this is the example of that living things grow. Okay, now come here. See this figure. Here there is a cow and thus eating grass. Okay, living things need food to live. Okay, now my dear students, underline also this line. This line is also very very important. Living things need food to live. Okay, so see this figure. There is a cow and a cow is eating grass. That means living things need food to live and survive. Okay, now see this figure. Living things move. There is a horse. Okay, and the horse is running. Okay, that means living things move from one place to another. And underline this line also and you have to memorize this line. Living things move. Okay, all these are the characteristics of living things. Okay, now come here. Living things give birth to babies like themselves. See this figure. There is an elephant and there is a baby elephant. Okay, these are the example of that living things give birth to babies like themselves. Okay, my dear students, see this. See here, there is new word. Okay, new word, breed. What is the meaning of breed? This is word meaning. Okay, what is the meaning of breed? To take in and give out air. Breed means to take in and give out air. My dear students, memorize properly this word meaning, breed. Okay, to take in and give out air. Now come to next page. Plants are also living things. My dear students, this line is also important. Underline this one. Plants are also living things. A baby plant is born from a seed and grows to be a big plant. Plants need food and air to grow. This line is also very, very important. Plants need food and air to grow. What do plants need? Plants need food and air to grow. Now, plants cannot move from one place to another. This one is also very, very important line. This one is also question answer. Okay, plants cannot move from one place to another, but they can move their body parts. Okay, plants cannot move from one place to another, but they can move their body parts. Just like the sunflower turns its face towards the sun. Sunflower example is sunflower turns its face towards the sun, and the leaves of touch me not plant close when we touch. That means there is a plant which is called Lajjavati plant, and when we touch them, they can close their leaves. Okay, my dear students, now come to this figure. Look at this figure. There is non-living things. Okay, now we'll discuss about non-living things. Look at this picture. What can we say? See the, here, we can see there is a house, there is a chair or table, and many more things. Okay, the things shown in the picture are called non-living things, and these things do not need. Okay, that means non-living things do not need air to breathe. Non-living things do not need air to breathe, food to live. They do not grow and move or give birth to young ones. Okay, these are the characteristics of non-living things. And example of non-living things are chair, table, pencil, books, bag, bat, ball, cars, buses, etc. All are non-living things. Now, non-living things can be divided into two groups, my dear students. Non-living things can be divided into two groups. These are very, very important line. Non-living things are divided into two groups: natural things and man-made things. Okay, what is natural things? Now we'll discuss about natural things. Natural things are found in the nature. Natural things are found in the nature. They are a gift to us by God. And what is man-made things? We'll discuss about man-made things now. Man-made things are not found in nature. Man-made things are not found in nature. They are made by people. Okay, natural things, non-living things can be divided into two groups: natural things and man-made things. Natural things are found in nature. They are gift. They are a gift to us by God. And man-made things are not found in nature. They are made by people. Okay, my dear students, come to next page. And there are some examples of natural things and man-made things. Okay, look at the picture. This one is mountains and clouds. Okay, this one is mountains and clouds. This one is moons, moon and stars. And this one is water and stones. Okay, all these things are natural things. Okay, these are the example of natural things. And now see this picture. There is a chair, a car, there are some books. Okay, all these things are man-made things. We can made this. Okay, that means man-made things are found in nature and they are made by people. We can made these things. And natural things, mountain, and clouds, moon and stars, water and stones. We cannot make these things. They are a gift to us by God. That means these things are natural things, okay? And these things are man-made things. My dear students, now, points to remember from the chapter, and you have to memorize this also. People, plants and animals are living things, okay? People, plants and animals are living things. Living things eat food, okay? Living things eat food. Living things grow, move and breathe. Living things have babies, and non-living things are natural or man-made. My dear students, now come to next page, page number 16, and it will be your SW, as your SW, okay? My dear students, do this SW properly and submit it on Saturday, that means 13 February. This is SW number 2, this is SW number 2, and SW, your SW topic is chapter 2. Page number 16. This is page number 16. Okay. Do this SW properly and submit it on Saturday. That means 13 February. My dear students, hope you have understood our today's topic properly. Read this chapter properly and memorize the underlined line, and keep practicing at home. Do your SW properly and submit it on due date. And my dear students, see you again in the next class. Allah Hafiz.